Well, believe it or not, some scientists think that the first person who will live to the age of 150 has already been born. Researchers are making breakthrough discoveries and unlocking the secrets to longer life. So how can we stay younger longer? Just watch.
Even though we can't stay young forever, Dr. Richard Furman says there are steps we can take to live younger, longer. Dr. Furman has been a vascular surgeon for over 30 years and says health problems associated with age can be prevented. In his book, Prescription for Life, Dr. Furman shares his strategic plan for maintaining the healthiest body possible, now and throughout our golden years.
And Dr. Richard Furman is here with us now. His book is called Prescription for Life, Three Simple Strategies to Live Younger Longer. And it's so nice to meet you, the man who's going to keep us younger longer. And, you know, you have shocking statistics in your book. Half of all Americans will die because of what is going on in their arteries. Tell us, what's going on in our arteries?
Well, Wendy, the health of our arteries determines the aging process. And just real quickly, there's good cholesterol and there's bad cholesterol. The bad cholesterol, the LDL cholesterol, is like little splinters that gets into your arteries. The good cholesterol, the hero HDL, takes those little splinters out. And that aging process is going on in everyone.
Well, one of the scary things, we may never have any symptoms of arterial damage until we get a stroke or even die. So how can we tell if we have a problem?
That's the scary part, and that's what Prescription for Life is all about prevention, because 80% of everyone over the age of 50 has some significant blockage in their arteries without causing any symptoms. That's the heart, the brain.
Significant blockage.
That's the blockage, significant blockage. So you don't want to wait till symptoms. Two-thirds of the time with a heart attack, the first symptom is a full-blown heart attack. So don't wait on symptoms.
Sorry to interrupt. That blockage is caused from what we're eating, right?
Caused from that bad cholesterol that we're eating, the wrong foods.
So the bacon that we love.
Right.
Okay, we're going to get to that in a minute. But you said that the clogging of the arteries, it leads to more than just heart disease. You've also say it's linked to Alzheimer's. How so?
Well, there's a lot. I think the Prescription for Life is a review of the medical literature written in layman's terms. And there's one good article, the Journal of the American Medical Association, that I think says it all. That Alzheimer's, they took 1,800 people, followed them for 14 years, and this is what they found. The ones that ate properly, like we're talking about, against the ones that didn't eat properly, they had a 40% more chance of Alzheimer's than the ones that ate poorly.
Okay, so what are the three lifestyle changes that we all need to make if we want to live in younger, longer?
Well, there are only three that we have control of, and that's the foods that we eat or we don't eat, our weight, we determine our own weight, nobody forces us to eat, and whether we exercise or not.
Well, let's start with the foods. We already know the bad foods that we shouldn't eat. Well, we know the good foods we should eat. We know the fruits and the vegetables and the lean meats and fish. What are foods that we should be avoiding at all costs?
Well, there are six. We won't have time to go in all six, but I'll tell you the one food that Americans eat the most of, that gives us the most saturated fat, that gives us those little splinters, the LDL cholesterol splinters, is cheese.
Really? I love cheese. You're kidding.
That was my favorite food. All my patients brought me cheese at Christmas. But I read that article, and in that moment I said, you know, I don't want my last 10, 15 years to be drooling, to be terrible last years of my life. Plus, you can be physiologically younger now. So I gave up cheese. If I could have given that up, anybody could.
I thought you were going to say, you know, bacon because it's pure fat and delicious, or a big juicy steak. But you're saying cheese. It's amazing. But look at the French. They eat less of cheese, and they're slender, and I don't know how long they live. They might not live to be 150. But, okay, so let's move on to maintaining our weight is number two thing that we need to do to live healthier longer. What is a healthy weight?
Well, the BMI is what the government goes by, but it gives you like a 30 or 40 pound difference. Go to prescriptionforlife.com and explain how to get to an ideal weight. But The main thing is less than 12% of Americans are at ideal weight, so don't worry about that. Assume you are overweight, and how do you get that excess weight off? And that's the key.
And then just how dangerous is a sedentary life? We know exercise is actually, that's the number three thing, a life of exercise.
Right.
How dangerous to our arteries is a sedentary life?
It's probably one of the most dangerous things that we do, and over half of Americans are completely sedentary. They don't do any exercise at all. And it takes 6 or 7 years off of your life expectancy. If you can't walk a quarter of a mile in 5 minutes, you're 30% more likely to die in the next 3 years than someone who can. And those are pretty tough numbers, but it puts it in perspective how important to get off that couch. And even if you're just going to do brisk walking, you need an exercise plan that you're going to follow yourself, even if it's brisk walking, because that emphasizes to you what else you need to be doing.
Okay, so if you eat a little piece of cheese and then you go for a brisk walk, are you going to counter those? Are they going to rule each other out?
No, these three lifestyles intertwine.
I'm trying, people. I'm trying to get us to be able to eat cheese here.
They intertwine.
Okay.
And you can't pick one or two and leave the other one out. And there's many stories in Prescription of Life that explain someone that looks, a football coach that looks healthy, right. He exercises good weight, but he had the highest cholesterol I've ever seen reported. And we put him on this plan, and in 2 months, he had normal cholesterol.
Okay.
So that's the one thing he was leaving out was the food. So you can't, you've got to do them all three.
All right. Well, we will forgive you about the cheese if it helps us to live younger, longer.
Right.
Dr. Furman, it was a pleasure. And if you want more of his insight, and I know you do, into the three simple strategies, you can get his book. It's called Prescription for Life, and it's available in stores nationwide. God bless you, and thanks so much for sharing your insights.
Well, thanks for having me, Linda.